So this is a demonstration video for anybody that wants to try the 1.5 optional art practice. This is quilling. This is an image of what your project should look like when it's done. Basically, you roll pieces of paper and glue them down on top of the design that we drew in 1.4. So I'm just going to run through really quickly and show you how to do that. So here is my workspace, and here's the drawing that I did for 1.4. And now I'm just gonna work on putting down the three-dimensional quilling strips of paper. So I have three sheets of the white construction paper here. And in Edio, you use a ruler and measure lines and then cut them. But I'm not really worried too much about that. I'm just gonna go ahead without measuring and cut a pretty straight line. I think the thing that they're really worried about is and I'm doing three sheets at a time just to be a little bit quicker with the instructions. But I think that they want your lines to be super straight so that when you glue them down, the edges of your paper are flat against the background. For me, it would be this black piece of paper here. And it won't, the glue will touch all parts. But I'm not really worried about that. And you can draw lines if you want. I'm just not going to because I kind of like the element of surprise when things are just a little bit different. So that's all I'm going to cut for now. And then when you make your sheets of quilling, you just take a piece of paper like this and you just roll it like around a pencil or straw or something like that, and it'll become curved like this, right? And then you're just going to glue it down. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take some Elmer's glue and I'm going to put some glue down. Just really light, just a light coat of Elmer's glue. Because I want it to dry. I want it to dry pretty quickly and I don't want it to be all gloopy and stuff, right? So I'm going to just make this a little bit tighter. And then I'm just going to put it down there. I'm just going to hold it for a second until it. You can also put a piece of tape around it. I'm going to glue this down. Like this. And just hold it for a second until it dries. Now I'm going to work on the rest of these. And any glue that you can see down there on the black paper, when it dries, it'll be clear. So I'm just going to keep doing that all over the place, and I'll come back and check in every time I think of something that I want to tell you. So I have switched from using a pencil to make my coils to using, I have a this paintbrush, and it's just a little bit thinner, in a circumference than a pencil. And so I was just looking at some people, and they were using these kits, quilling kits that they got from art stores. And they were using this tool that was really skinny and making these really, really, really tight coils. And so I was like, oh, I wonder if this will work better if I use something that's gonna make my coil just a little bit thicker. And so, yeah, I decided I was gonna go with this. Now, here's a coil. And so what I'm gonna do now is just like open it up a little bit, make it a little bit bigger. And you can kind of pull on it and make it as big as you want. And then I'm gonna glue it to itself so that it's kind of like in this size coil permanently. And I'm gonna glue it down right here. And that's a curved area. So I'm gonna turn it into a little bit of a teardrop shape by squeezing one of the ends. And now I'm gonna also bend it so that it's kind of curved a little bit, make it a little bit nicer curve than that, so that it kind of fits right, kind of like hugs right around there. And so I know that you're not supposed to use a ton of glue, but I'm not bothered by using a lot of glue because it's gonna dry clear. So I'm just gonna put it right there so that it's helping with that curve a little bit. Let me move it over so it's right underneath the camera so you can kind of see how that kind of works in there. So I'm just gonna keep doing it, going around. When I get down here, I'm going to show you how to make them really big to like fit in that whole space, but I'm gonna just keep going and filling all that in. Now you can be using all different color construction paper, you know, to make it very yours very colorful, but I think I really am just gonna stick with the black and white until the whole thing is filled in. All right, let me get back to it. So I've got this one leg. I'm gonna call it a leg. Kind of starting to look like an octopus to me now. And these are kind of like bubbles in the water. That's how I'm seeing it. But I've got to the end of this leg, and I just want to show you how I'm gonna fill this one up. So here's a coil that I just finished, and I'm just gonna open it up just a little bit. I don't want it to be open a lot, just a little bit. I'm gonna pull it apart, and then I'm gonna glue it onto itself, but I'm gonna leave like a big tail kind of like hanging off the end. I'm gonna glue it back here. So I'm putting a little bit of glue on the coil, and then I'm gonna have this tail sticking out, and then I'm gonna squeeze it so it becomes teardrop shape, becomes teardrop drop shape with this little tail kind of sticking out. Right. And so I'm also going to squeeze it over here and make it kind of like a little bent, curved around. So that's going to fit right there. And then this part I'm going to glue onto the coil that's prior to it. So let me just bend that a little bit more. I want to open it up. I don't want it to be completely closed down. So I'm going to put some glue on this area that's going to attach to the coil that's prior, and I'm going to put some glue down on the paper, and then I'm just going to kind of slide it right in there. So it takes up all that space, just like that. I'm just going to hold it for a couple of seconds so that it sticks. And that's how I ended that one. All right, so I just have four more to do. And then I'm done. And I think it'll look a lot cleaner once all the glue that you can see kind of inside the coils dries and it starts to look more solidified. Okay, so here is my quilling design. And I only have one more little piece to do right here. So I'm gonna do that right now. I got my skinny little paintbrush handle here. So I'm gonna just make this coil, the last one. I like the way it kind of turned out. I definitely would mind not doing it. I would like to do it again and use some color. 'Cause now that it's done, I thought black and white would look really cool. And it does, it looks okay. But really, color is the superstar here, right? So as this coil kind of unwraps a little bit, I'm gonna make it just a little bit bigger, right? And now I'm gonna glue it to itself, but I'm gonna leave a little tail. I found that leaving the little tail on there helps to secure it into place. So I'm gonna glue that down, but leave the tail, and then I'm gonna pinch it so it's pointy on one end. This is called a teardrop, but that's going to fit in there, and it needs to kind of be shaped more like that, right? So it can fit in there. So I just pinched it on the side to get it to be kind of shaped the right way. Right. And now I'm going to put some glue on it here and here where I'm going to attach it to the piece before it. I'm going to put glue down on the paper. So this does not seem to be really kind of like the way that people on YouTube have done their quilling projects. They seem to be a lot more organized than I have been, but hey, you know what? Actually, it's the first one I've ever made, and so I'm gonna put one more in this hole here, and I might put one more in that top circle after I get done doing this. But I just want to kind of make those top ones a little bit more white, a little bit more filled. So there, I got my little coil, and I'm going to tape it. I'm sorry, I'm going to glue it shut like that. And I'm going to put a little bit of glue in there like that. And then I'm just going to sink this in there. Wow, it fit perfectly. So yeah, I think I might do that for this top one too, but I'll do that later, and then I'll show it to you in class. All right, everybody, enjoy your quilling project. Super relaxing and super fun.